Just when you think you've seen it all, ladies and gentlemen, it just keeps getting better on the Mikey Pipes Pipe Doctor YouTube channel. I am going to refrain from using any vulgar words during this episode, but what I'm about to show you, you may fall on the floor. So viewer discretion is advised. So we have this nice kitchen. Look at this. And just so you see, we have a boiler. There's a cast iron boiler right there, right? Laundry room, very nice. Nice kitchen. We have the side-by-side freezer and refrigerator. You have an island gas cooktop. You should get an inductive stove. You have all the solar panels on your roof, right? And I'm here because his air conditioning, his ductless mini split system for this room isn't cooling, right?
Yeah.
How long has it been installed for?
15 years.
Okay, so it's not an installation problem, but just guys, just start falling on the floor right now. Are the cabinet doors only open or closed?
They close also during the winter.
So you keep these open during the
summer?
During the summer, yeah. And you close it in the winter?
Yes.
Wow. Ever think about maybe putting it like on a motor and it'll open automatically when you turn the ductless unit on? Wow. Hold on, you ever think about doing that? Like a motorized louver or a motorized kitchen cabinet. Come on, who put this in?
I'd rather pay pipe.
Can you tell me who put this in? Because I want to smack the shit out of them. There's no way you allow this to go down like this.
We asked them to do it. Like,
why?
Slowman's, actually.
Slowman's?
Yeah.
Oh my God, no way.
It was a whole discussion, and we insisted on it because we had an air conditioner there before, and it worked great, and this has...
You had an air conditioner there before?
Yeah.
So, stupid was done beforehand, and stupid continues to get done. Just, you can't be, you gotta be bullshit. Okay, so, do you clean the filters?
Yeah.
You can get to them?
The
yeah?
Yeah, definitely.
So the filters are clean, the unit turns on, but it's just not cooling.
Well, we have two units, and both of them aren't cooling. Probably a Freon issue.
Refrigerant, yes. Puron.
Yeah. Exactly.
You know Puron's phased out now.
Freon or?
Puron.
Oh, yeah. No, this uses Freon, actually. Yeah.
This doesn't use Freon. This doesn't use R22. This uses R410A.
It's still, it's right after Sandy's.
Yeah, so Puron.
Oh, okay. Oh, yes. Interesting, actually. Yeah. Yes. Oh, so what happened?
So Puron has been phased out thanks to the previous administration who run the United States government.
Okay.
Under some kind of Infrastructure Reinvestment Act or something, but there's an EPA law that January 1st, 2025, the production and sale of R410A equipment shall cease.
Interesting. Yeah.
And it's been replaced by what we call an A2L refrigerant.
Okay.
Now, the people, the powers that be that make crap like this, they haven't decided on one refrigerant, so now we have two refrigerants. We have, by the way, A2L is a flammable refrigerant.
Okay, interesting.
Flammable.
Uh-huh.
We have a flammable refrigerant that is the gas that acts as the medium that extracts heat from our homes and brings it outside, and in the winter, it takes heat from outside and brings it into our home.
Interesting.
Yes. So you have this A2L refrigerant.
Uh-huh.
But as I was saying, the manufacturers, like Fujitsu, Carrier, Daikin, these people decided that, you know what, we're not going to settle on like R410A Puron for that's going to be accepted. Mm-hmm. No.
Is that my phone?
That's me.
Okay.
No. The Daikin group is going to use R32.
Uh-huh.
And everyone else is going to use R454B.
Interesting.
But guess what, ladies and gentlemen? If you go on eBay right now and look for R454B, 25 pounds is sometimes sold for around $2,200.
Wow, that's insane.
Want to know why? Because you can't buy R454B because there's a shortage on the containers that hold this flammable refrigerant. Ain't that make perfect sense, folks? You can't make this stuff up. Right? So there's two refrigerants. The majority of manufacturers use R454B, which you can't get anywhere. If I call 20 distributors, everyone's going to tell you they're going to start laughing at me on the phone.
No kidding. That's crazy. Yeah.
The ones that have it will only sell it to you if you buy X amount of dollars of equipment that uses it, and they'll sell you a little bit.
Interesting.
Yeah. But I found a source, and I'm not going to tell you because I need it. Now, back to the original scheduled program. Well, here's the outdoor unit. At least they use liquid type for the communication wire. Turns on, no error code. Weird, because let me show you. We go inside the boiler room with the line set from the kitchen. So we, there's the unit in the kitchen. Comes out, goes across here. Goes into the boiler room. And then out there. And it connects here. So, yeah. Fun. By the way, see that unit over there? I did that one. See? It says Pipe Doctor on it. I did that one. All right. Yeah, it's another gas and go. Gas and go, baby. 14 pounds.
4 pounds, 14 ounces.
Keeping it real. Gas and go, baby. Come on. Think I'm going to put lipstick on a pig? I don't care how retarded the system is installed. It wasn't installed yesterday, last week, next month, last year. It was installed 12 years ago, 13 years ago. And it works until it doesn't have refrigerant. So if the homeowner's okay with that, it's not my house. I don't have to worry about what it looks like. As long as the homeowner's happy, we deliver comfort. Don't forget it. Yeah, I even put my sticker on it. I don't care. Customer satisfaction is what we deliver. Smash that thumbs up button. You know you want to.